Why women cheat on their husbands. Why women cheat on their husbands. That is a conversation today. Hey, my name is Kwame Frempon. I am a marriage and family therapist.
My name is Mary Frimpong, and it's always good to come your way.
Thank you so very much. This channel is about mental health, self, and relationship improvement. If you are here for the first time, please like us, share, subscribe, turn on your notification so you don't miss out on our weekly videos. So today we are talking about why women cheat on their husbands. You know, 65% of men and 55% of women will have extramarital affair by the time they are 40 years in their marriage. That is very high number, you know. So, and they are saying that being a Christian doesn't stop you from having, from being tempted to have an affair.
Yeah.
You know, the issue is that every physical affair begins with an emotional affair.
Okay.
Yeah, oftentimes we talk about physical affair, but we don't talk about emotional affair.
Okay.
When you cannot take the person's name out of your mind, if you have to see the person.
Yeah, and I don't know why that is.
In fact, in our professional calling, we are told that if you're going to see a client and you begin to, you know, all the time, a particular client, you have to spray yourself, look at a particular way, dress a particular way. For that particular client, they say, check your heart. Something is wrong. You need to talk to your supervisor because, see, these are very, very important things that we need to do. But why do women cheat on their husbands? Today we have 10 reasons why women do that. The first one is called spouse poaching. They call it partners predators. There are some people, may, their aim is to go for married couples.
Yeah.
In fact, the other day, somebody told me that one lady says, this year, I will go for somebody's husband. This year, I will go for somebody's husband.
Yeah.
And there are some people that is what they are looking for, to go after married couples. And do you know why they do that?
Why?
Three major reasons. Number one, they said that married couples have qualities they are looking for. When it comes to spouse poaching, people like to chase married people.
Yeah, because they know they can commit.
They can commit.
Yeah.
You know, they are stable. And they are reliable.
Yeah.
And they are family people, so they can commit to that. That is one of the reasons why people go after married people in general, that people. But when it comes to women who are married and why they cheat on their husbands, why? Number one reason is that lack of boundaries.
Yeah, maybe they are seeking attention somewhere that they are not getting.
Getting at home.
At home.
Because when they go home, you know, it's like boring.
Yeah.
You know, the man is saying nothing. Yeah. It's so one day, you know, she goes to work. Hey, you look beautiful, girl. Hey, you look this. And the compliments keep going and going and going. It twists the heart.
Yeah. And while we are not saying it's good for women to cheat on their husbands, we are appealing to the men to compliment your wives.
I'm telling you.
If they look beautiful, let them know they look beautiful.
I'm telling you.
Don't say it in your head. That you are thinking in your head,
yes,
oh, my wife looks good.
Yes.
But then you are not telling her.
Yeah.
If she goes out and somebody compliments her,
yes,
she's going to get closer to that person. So let's compliment our wives. It's very, very important.
It is critically necessary. That, again, I like what you said. We are not saying that should be an excuse to cheat on your husband. But husbands must learn to compliment their wives. And I think vice versa.
Yeah.
We all do need, you know, I told you that I don't know about other preachers. But no matter how I preach or teach, no matter how well somebody said it, it must come from you, right?
Yeah.
I said it.
Yeah, you did.
And if you are quiet, I feel like I'd preach a horrible sermon.
Yeah. Yeah. So I always also always try to.
You do
yeah,
that.
I tell you.
Being
that
creative.
Was good.
Yes.
Yeah.
You know, sometimes you send me text messages.
Yeah.
That is very important.
Mm-hmm.
We all need to speak well to each other.
Yeah.
Compliment.
Mm-hmm.
It is a Christian thing to do.
Yeah.
You know, when Adam says, "Who you are the bone of my bones and the flesh of my flesh." I said, Eve stood there. I said, Eve, say something, sister. Talk to Adam. Tell Adam something.
Well, Eve was surprised. I mean, he just met the man.
The man.
He just met the man.
And the man just went, wow. You know, so compliment is critical.
Mm-hmm.
It is not an excuse to cheat.
Yeah.
However, it is critical.
Yeah.
Because attention... from husbands who mean a lot to wives.
Yeah. And also, if the woman doesn't feel appreciated,
mm-hmm.
she will find it somewhere.
Yes. If you don't feel appreciated,
yeah.
and you are not solid.
Yeah, that's right.
With your Christian life.
That is
walk.
The key word. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah.
If you're not solid, if you're not strong with God, you're going to want to get it from somewhere else.
From somewhere else, yeah.
And it's, again, it's both. It's, mm-hmm. is you have to look at it from both angles. Men, women, husbands, wives. We all need this. We need to have time for each other,
mm-hmm.
compliment each other, and appreciate one another.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's a good point. Then the other thing, too, is that emotional affair is one key open door
mm-hmm.
for why women cheat on their husbands.
Mm-hmm.
Emotional affair. You know, we're not doing anything wrong.
Mm-hmm.
We are just friends.
Mm-hmm.
He's just friends. Why? But the Bible says the heart is desperately wicked above all things.
Mm-hmm.
Who can tell? Who
mm-hmm.
can know?
Mm-hmm.
So emotional affair. We talk about the lack of attention on husband. Social media is number
again.
Seven. Social media, yes. Social media.
Yeah.
You will not believe how people marriage have fallen apart due to social media network. You know, sometimes somebody is sending you a friend request. Is that you? Wow. Hey, this is whatever. Maybe this is the name. And then you begin to remember years ago, maybe the person was your ex.
Mm-hmm.
So if your ex is befriending you on social media and you are married,
mm-hmm.
it can cause some issues.
Yeah, and I mean, not only your ex. Sometimes you know how people will request friendship
mm-hmm.
and you look at their page and there are some people you know
yeah.
on their page. So mm-hmm. you accept the friendship.
Mm-hmm.
For me, if you send any...
request.
Anything
yeah.
that I feel is inappropriate, I'll just delete you.
Yes. I do that all the time.
Yeah. I'll just delete
you know, and
people do that.
Yes. So you have to be very, very careful.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, there was a time somebody requested friendship and I realized that he had requested a friendship. So he was a friend to a friend I know,
mm-hmm.
a pastor friend I know. So I called the pastor friend and said, are you a friend to this particular individual? And then he says, she just requested me. So I had said yes. And then she sent an inappropriate text message.
Mm-hmm.
What color do you want?
Oh. Mm-hmm.
You know, and then immediately you are gone.
Yeah, that's
you know?
Right.
So mm-hmm. you really want to have boundaries. Nobody is perfect, but you cannot let down your guard because extramarital affair can be very expensive. It affects marriages and families and
yeah.
children
yeah.
and so many other things,
mm-hmm.
reputation,
yeah.
integrity.
Mm-hmm.
So if you know that, I mean, one time I read a story about this guy who he realized that his heart was moving towards somebody he knows at workplace. He was a deacon in his church, but he couldn't take that individual's female mind from his mind. And then he comes home, he doesn't even pay attention to his wife anymore. all he's thinking about is this lady giving him the attention and compliment. Oh, how are you doing? You want to eat for lunch? What do you want to? It's like an angel of God. And he realized that it was affecting him so bad. He made a good decision, excuse me. He told his counselor that it's a matter of time before he committed extramarital affair. Mm-hmm. He said, counselor, it is about time. I'm getting closer and closer and closer. Well, the counselor says to him, if you know that it's about to happen, mm-hmm. I'm going to give you advice. You may not like it. You know what he told him to do?
Quit your job.
Quit your job. Now, that may not be your case. He quit his job, moved his wife out of town. Issues resolved. Now, you may say maybe it may happen again, but that is what he did. Whatever it takes to safeguard your marriage, you must do it. So, social media, the other one is time factor. People don't have time.
At all.
Especially here in America. There's mm-hmm. no time. And it's not anybody's fault.
No. You gotta pay the bills.
You gotta pay the bills. One person work in the morning, another person work in the night. Mm-hmm. And if you have a business, you are busy, 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 busy. There's no time.
Yeah, so we have to be intentional.
We got to be intentional. When I first came to America, there's something I learned from both the Caucasians and African-American pastor friends of mine. They date their spouse once a week. Mm-hmm. I never heard that in Ghana. Did you hear that in Ghana?
No.
No? And it's something that we all need to learn, including myself. We need to learn that. Mm-hmm. That we date, we take one day out of the week purposely for your spouse. Because you know what I find out? The study says, when couples time, your job will take time away. Mm-hmm. Church will take some away. Your children will take some away. Everything will take some away. And then the marriage itself mm-hmm. doesn't have any time left. Mm-hmm. If you don't be intentional, it's gone. When it comes to why women cheat their husbands, the research says this, number 9, says it's the lack of intimacy. Mm-hmm. Lack of intimacy. That connectedness, to be able to connect with your spouse. You come from work, hey, how was your day? Mm-hmm. Let's sit down and talk. Let's watch some movies. You know, we are working together. We are in the kitchen, maybe taking shower together. But that connecting, if you lose it, it's not good.
Yeah.
The marriage.
And sometimes it happens gradually.
It does happen. And it just baby steps.
Yeah.
Baby steps. It can happen to anybody, anytime. Mm-hmm. You know, you have to be intentional. Number 10 is retribution. People commit a extramarital affair because their spouse cheat on them.
Yeah. They'll always say, yeah, but he cheated on me too, so
I have to cheat because, you know, that happens. And in a way of, you know, that is the only way that they can feel good, because if you cheat on me, I'll cheat on you. Mm-hmm. Here are the things that we share today, and I hope that it will help somebody open your eyes to know how we need to safeguard our marriage.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for watching. Share, subscribe, and tell others. Send us comments. Any questions you may have, join the conversation. And again, thank you for watching.
God bless you.
God bless.